This is the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 19. For the wisdom of this world is foolishness with the Most High. For it is written, he taketh the wise in their own craftiness. Brakathi Yahweh, Brakathi Yahweh Shai. Brakathi Yahweh, Brakathi Yahweh Shai. Brakathi Yahweh, Brakathi Yahweh Shai. Bahashem, Rakah Kodash. Double honors to the apostles and elders of great millstone who teach well and rule well, who taught me this truth. Peace and salutation to the Achim, the fellow laborers, the hopeful elect, pushing this truth at risk of their own lives throughout the four corners of the earth. And to the awkward listening, listening and learning, Shalom. We'll get right into it. 1 Corinthians 3, verse 19, and it reads, for the wisdom of this world is foolishness with the Most High, right? The wisdom of this world. Right, Esau's wisdom, Esau's technology, Esau's money system, it's foolishness in the eyes of the Most High. Everything that Jake out here, two-thirds of our people out here, place emphasis on, place value on, right, this rat race, this money system, right? Esau's technology, it's foolishness in the eyes of the Most High, Yahweh Shem El Shai. And ultimately, the Most High, Yahweh Shem El Shai, is going to take it down, right? It's in the beginning of being brought low, right? We're seeing the money system taking a crap, right? All these other nations are moving away from the greenback, right? Inflation at an all-time high, right? And it's going to get higher, right? Food shortages being now in the mainstream media, beginning with the elder apostles on down, been telling you about food shortages coming. Now mainstream media, the media that two thirds trust in, the media that these heathen nations trust in, the NBC, the commercial news stick, the commercial media outlets, NBCs, ABCs, CNNs, Fox News. Right now they're reporting on food shortages. Right? And these things are going to increase. Jeremiah 22 verse 13. And it reads, woe unto him. Right? And this is what the Lord is doing. Woe unto him. Destruction. Woe means destruction. That buildeth his house by unrighteousness. Unrighteousness. Who built their house? Who built their whole system on unrighteousness? America. And his chambers by wrong. Chambers. You look into the Hebrew word for chambers. The meaning is upper room. Lofty. Right? Is it America, the great Babylon, the great lofty? Looks down on everybody else. That useth his neighbor's service without wages, right? Going back to the slaves, going back to the hardcore slaveries, man. Services without wages. Right, America the Great, Babylon the Great was founded on free labor. Hardcore servitude. And giveth him not for his work, right? And the slaves, Northern Kingdom and Southern Kingdom, were not paid, man. It was hardcore bondage. Right? So this scripture is saying, woe unto him. Right? America the Great. Babylon the Great. Right? And we see it collapsing. We see it collapsing. The scriptures are speaking loud and clear. Habakkuk 2 verse 12. Woe to him that buildeth a town with blood, America. Buildeth a town with blood. Built up on blood. That's why it's got to be destroyed. Right? Scripture in Numbers. Is it Numbers or Deuteronomy? Numbers. think it's Numbers. Buildeth the city on blood. Numbers 34. Salakia. Numbers 35, verse 33. So ye shall not pollute the land wherein ye are. For blood, it defileth the land. And the land cannot be cleansed of the blood that is shed therein, but by the blood of him that shed it. Right. So all the blood shedding that Esau Edom did in the land of America, all the lynching, all the smallpox blankets. Right. Slave patrols, slave catchers, the sword, all that blood that was spilt. Right. Has to be cleansed of the blood of by the blood of him that shed it. So all you that shed, all you that committed these atrocities, Esau, Edom, these banking families, the ruling class elites. Right, your blood's got to be shed, and who's going to shed it? Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai. Habakkuk 2, verse 12, once again. Woe to him that buildeth a town with blood. Woe. Woe means destruction. And establisheth a city by iniquity. Establish it. Built up a city by iniquity. Iniquity is sin upon sin. Right? There's no law, statute, commandments going forth in America the Great, Babylon the Great. It's nothing but wickedness. Right? Nothing but wickedness. Right? Alphabet Boy community on all-time high. Right? Colored flags. Right? You know what I'm talking about. Everywhere. Isaiah 5 verse 20. And it reads, woe unto them that call evil good. Right? That call evil good. It says here, woe unto them, meaning destruction, that call evil good and good evil. America, that put darkness for light, darkness for light, and light for darkness, demonizing the truth. That put bitter for sweet, and sweet for bitter, right? So the Most High Yahweh Shai is going to judge this place, man. This place is upside down. This place is backwards. This place is founded on blood. Founded on lies. Founded on deceit. Right? This place is through, man. The money system is collapsing. The food chain has been broken. Right? Proverbs 22, verse 16, it reads, He that oppresseth the poor to increase his riches, the poor. Who are the poor? You Israelites. Israel being a people before a place. Right? He that oppresseth the poor to increase his riches, right? To get wealth. And he that giveth to the rich, right? Props up his props up those that lie in bed with him. Right? Props up the banks. Props up the banking, the banking families, ruling class elite. Whoever lies in bed with these ruling class elites, right, gets propped up. Shall surely come to want. Shall surely come to want. Right? Shall surely come to want. Meaning guaranteed you will want. Right? Guaranteed you're going to be broken. Shall surely come to want. Right? The Most High, Yahweh Shem Yahshua, is guaranteeing you that they will come to want. Jeremiah 17, verse 11. As the partridge sitteth on eggs and hatcheth them not, so he that getteth riches and not by right, right? He that getteth riches and not by right. And how did America, they get their riches? Deceit, lies, robbery, right? Shall leave them in the midst of his days, shall leave his riches in the midst of his days. Right? You banking families, you ruling class elites, right? Collapsing this thing on purpose to bring in your grain of rice. The Spirit of the Lord is on you to do that. It's the Lord's will. And the scriptures say it's not gonna work. Does it say disappointed? Let's get that. In a disappointed the devices. Job chapter 5, verse 12, and it reads, he disappointeth the devices of the crafty, right? The Lord Yahweh Shem Yahshua disappointeth the devices. What are the what is their device? Ultimately going into the grain of rice, right? But all their deception, all their enchantments are their devices on a grand scale, but ultimately leading into the grain of rice. Job 5 verse 12, he disappointed the devices of the crafty so that their hands cannot perform their enterprise, right? So that they can't fulfill it, so that they can't fulfill their work, right? The Most High had them in a trick bag. Back into Jeremiah 17 verse 11 once again, I'll close out. As the partridge sitteth on eggs and hatcheth them not, so he that getteth riches and not by right shall leave them in the midst of his days, right? In the midst of Esau, Edom, going through what it is the Spirit of Yahweh Shem Yahshua has on him to do, right? His NWO, his grain of rice, right? Right, his riches shall leave them in the midst of his days, and at his end shall be a fool. Right, so ultimately the base man gonna be brought back down to being base. Right, at his end shall be a fool. Right, these ruling class elites think they're gonna get away from this thing. They're building bunkers, space station hideouts. Right, they're collapsing this thing on purpose. The grain of rice gonna come in. World War III gonna spark off. Yahweh Shai and the angels gonna crack that sky. Right? And put all you ruling class elites, all you banking families into subjection, hardcore slavery. Thus saith the scriptures. Shalom.